Hi there, welcome here on the channel for today's video that is going to be about ultralight 5-inch frames and setups. I made this video because I was the lucky winner of frame kit and motors from Brother Hobby. They was kind enough to send me this package after showing them a picture of my current 5-inch ultralight build for a small review of this new product, which is called the Hyperbola 5-inch ultralight frames and some Brother Hobby 2004 motors for this this build. So now let's see what's in the box. First of all, you have this 2X Hyperbola frame, 35 grams, 4 millimeter carbon, 12 up to 16 motors you can fit here. You can fit a 20 by 20 flight controller, whoop size IOFC as well. You have mounting patterns for the included gear I will show you just after, that comes in the form of a canopy and a top plate. And you also have an extra extra hole set on the outer size to fit a wider pod like the one from the Twig or the one I made for the Pickle Big. So you have a quite interesting set of options to build on such a frame. You also have strap passings which allow you to mount the battery sideways or frontways as you prefer. So you have basically all the options to get an ultralight 5-inch 5-inch build on this frame. The frame comes with two mounting options, as I said, this TPU pod where you can fit a micro size camera, I guess. You have a lot of room here to put up things. You have antenna holes. You have, I think this is a crossfire attach. And you also have the top plate version that comes with the front extender to put the camera here. You have a small piece for the rear to put some antenna on tubes behind the quad, and all the mounting gear that come with. The standoffs are really, really long. As you can see here, I think it's 40 millimeters M2 standoffs. Never see such standoffs yet on a build, but I think they make totally sense because the frame is intended to be used with the DJI HD gear. So basically, if you put the Vista in the frame, you need a lot of extra room to be able to fit everything. So taller standoffs are an interesting option, and I think you can probably while Brother Hobby recommends a HDLS just 35 IO flight controller, I think you can fit a stack and a Vista on top of it with such standoffs. So basically, you have a lot of options. You even have small adapters for a pod mount. You have screws. You have everything you need to build this. So the two options are really cool, and you also have some antenna tubes and battery pad to put under the frame and to attach the battery. The only thing you don't have is a battery strap, which is a bit bad, but I don't care because I have a lot, so it's not an issue for me. But it would have been nice to have one. Then you have those Gemfan Hurricane 5125 light blades that are really interesting on ultralight builds. You can even go with picture props. This one would be very fine and would work very, very smooth, I guess, for such setups. On my testing, I went with even picture one, and 5146 or something like that, I guess, and it was perfectly fine. What I like on this Gemfan new style of props is that they come with a small adapter here that will allow you to transform the prop hole that is intended for an M5 shaft, a common shaft you find on big motors, to transform it in a T-mount, in a small T-mount for smaller motors. I think it's really a clever solution to have props that can do both, in fact. And speaking about the motors, here are the Brother Hobby, obviously VY2004 3150 kV. Those are 4S motors, which is perfect for what I'm building and what I'm doing. I was very interested to try this one out because when they come on the market, I thought it was a perfect size for this kind of machine. That is, let's say, below 250 grams. It's a good size, so it will be a bit more torquey than what I used on this one, and kind of the same weight, I think, so around 60 grams. But they are really, really more powerful. They come with a T-mount, I guess 2 millimeter shaft, and they have a lot of thrust apparently from what I saw. You have a C clip on the bottom, and the mounting pattern is 12 millimeters. And that's about it for the motor. They look beautiful. I like them a lot. Really, a really beautiful motor. And that's about it for the gear I'm going to put on this one. First mount option with the top plate. You can see that it's really, really super tall, so you can fit up a lot of gear here if you want. Normal 20 by 20 stack plus Vista without any issue, I think. You have all the room you need to build this one. The weight is 51 grams in this configuration. You also have some shorter standoffs here that are the size of the pod here. So if you go with a single board, I guess you can use these ones. Second configuration with the provided canopy. Honestly, I'm not really sure if this thing could bring sufficient protection to the setup you put, because it's very soft. In fact, you can move it quite easily, so I'm not sure about this one. For the weight, let's see in this configuration, 40, let's say 45. And now comes the third option, which I could call the way of the pickle. So it's my pickle big pod on the external holes, so it provides some separation with the mounting of the flight controller that will be on the inner holes. And when you put it on the scale, it gives 42 grams. That is lighter than this pod option. And the camera and all the electronics will be better protected with this one. The mount will be lower profile and suitable for nano cameras. As I prefer my builds. Now let's put all the electronics and motors on this beautiful frame. What I have here is a Beta FPV 20 amps board that will be sufficient for this kind of setups, with an XT. XT60 connector to max out the power you get from the battery. Runcam Predator V4, and I don't know, I think the VTX is Ichin Nano VTX, which is a really simple one that works just well. That's it. So now let's build the Hyperbola frame and see how it goes once put up together and took out to a flight session. I added the Insta360 Go camera to get better footage and see something better than a simple DVR. So running two batteries through it for the Maiden, what I can say, it performs beautifully. The frame holds up. The wider wheelbase makes it fly really good with almost. I just used a preset on Emu Flight, which was quite close, I think 22 of 3 motors on 4S, and basically it flies perfectly out of the box. It's powerful, responsive, fast. It's really, really, really a nice machine to fly with this. With this prop motor combination, the flight time on my small 650 batteries is quite small. You can get 4 minutes of flights if you don't push it too hard, but if you push it really hard, it's a bit more complicated. So it would work better with a bigger battery, I think, something in the 1 amp, 1.3 amp, something more common for a 5 inch. But on my build, I'd have to change the battery holder and the connector to get something on the command size, let's say. But yes, I like it. I recommend you to get those beautiful motors. They are really well performing, very powerful, very smooth. And the frame, which are available from Brother Hobby, I guess. For the mounting option provided, they are quite common, but I prefer to go with my pod. It flies perfectly, and it's robust and compact, whatever you can want from this kind of machine. Thanks a lot for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.